distinguished by differences in body size, color and density of stripes, thickness of fur and tail width. The Siberian tiger, the rarest of those still remaining in the wild, is much larger than its cousin, the Bengal tiger. Its fur is also distinctly lighter, providing superb camouflage during the snowy winter months. For now, it's summer in China's northeastern province of Heilongjiang, and also unseasonably hot. The Siberian tiger takes its name from its normally icy cold homeland, and this tiger's thick, shaggy coat has seen better times. During the bitterest of the cold months, Siberian tigers will cover great distances in search of food. In fact, their range is greater than any of the other subspecies. But endurance and the most acute of senses don't make this killer infallible. Killing takes more than might, and a successful kill results from a blending of many skills. It's thought that about 50% of the tiger's hunting attempts are rewarded. The principal prey are deer and wild pig, but tigers will also devour birds and fish as the opportunity presents itself. Usually creeps to within 60 feet of its victim before pouncing and grabbing it by the neck. Death is swift for any prey. Large victims are down for the count, suffocated mercifully by a vice-like grip from the tiger's powerful jaws. Female tigers scent mark their boundaries with urine. Fluid from the anal glands mixes with urine to register a potent presence with other tigers. Trees and bushes become silent sentries as the tiger uses peaceful means to stamp his territory. Happening upon such a marker, another tiger will often emit an odd kind of grimace, somewhere between a snarl and a sneeze. Tigers also leave their feces behind as another indication of presence. Scraping the ground provides a stretching exercise, but the scent left behind also warns off other males. The Siberian tiger is one of the most solitary creatures on Earth, a choice born of necessity. Food is hard enough to find without sharing territory with other tigers. But there are always exceptions. A male tiger will always defend its range against another male, but not from a female, even when her boundaries overlap his. Other males are generally allowed to pass through, but most such detours result in spats. With fewer than 200 Siberian tigers remaining in the wild, this majestic animal is now protected by the highest level of the Chinese government. Still, conservationists are finding themselves confronted by centuries of cultural tradition in a region obsessed with its health. The bones of the tiger have long been sought after for their curative powers, and though the sale of tiger parts is now forbidden by Chinese law, the practice still flourishes on Asia's black markets. According to the principles of traditional Oriental medicine, ground tiger bone can heal rheumatism, the tiger's whiskers can soothe headaches, while its eyeballs can cure a range of illnesses from epilepsy to neurosis. The range of the tiger's mythical healing powers and the widespread availability of firearms have combined to decimate the tiger population across Asia. Here in China's only Siberian tiger reserve, tigers are taught to catch their own prey. It's a brutal but critical exercise. Most of these Siberian tigers were born in captivity, and the hunting skills learned here will mean survival in the event they are returned to the wild. So the tigers feast while wildlife keepers watch from the safety of a heavily barred truck. The keepers observe all they can of the tiger's behavior in the hopes of generating a new level of understanding. With 30 tigers sharing the reserve, there is bound to be some confrontation. A Siberian tiger who senses another male in his territory flattens his ears in the early signs of aggression. But in this case, it's all too hot. Is heeded, and this massive male continues his search for new territory. But there are few options in the heat of midday, and shade is at a premium. Unlike many mammals, tigers mate at any time of the year. Siberian tigers reach sexual maturity between 3 and 5 years, and once grown, there are two priorities, food and sex. Still, much of their mating action is relegated to colder months. Searing heat and a thick, shaggy coat are hardly conducive to foreplay, and often the male's advances will be met with ill humor. The female tempers her brush off by feigning submission. Rolling on her back, she can keep the big male interested and maintain the peace. The disgruntled male tiger also makes his feelings known. Few people have witnessed tigers eating grass. The animal's reputation as the supreme carnivore takes a bruising with scenes more reminiscent of a gentle vegetarian. Little is known of this tiger quirk, but a dog will eat grass to ease an upset stomach, and experts say the same remedy might apply to the tiger. This female has her eye on new pastures, and the male's chance is lost. He will have to find a new mate, one that has come into estrus. Female tigers are only receptive for a few days, and during this time a pair will mate many times. The male will leave then and begin the search for yet another female. Coat has seen better days. Every summer, the Siberian tiger sheds its patchy mane to reveal a splendid winter coat, striped black and yellow with white undersides that extend to the back legs and the tail. This new winter coat serves as a camouflage when snow covers the summer greenery. Often, the Siberian tiger endures temperatures 40 degrees below zero. So not only is its coat longer and thicker than other tigers, but it develops an extra layer of fat on its belly and flanks. This added insulation protects Siberian tigers against harsh wind and bitter cold. Camouflage is another essential factor in the survival of a Siberian tiger. While immensely powerful, the tiger's weight robs him of endurance, and he seldom outruns his prey. A tiger's ability to blend into the surrounding territory is vital to a successful hunt, adding stealth to power and cunning. There have been no actual sightings of the Siberian tiger in the wild for several years, but encroaching population has invaded areas which once belonged to the tiger, bringing inevitable tension. Siberian tigers are still a menace to livestock and rural communities along the Chinese-Russian border. Last year, the death of several oxen was attributed to a possible tiger attack. The wounds inflicted on the oxen were characteristic of the Siberian tiger. A death nip on the nape of the neck and deep scars from the unsheathed claws. The strength and formidable jaws of the Siberian tiger enable it to drag its prey hundreds of yards or more to a secure spot. There are many stories of the tiger's pulling power, some say equal to that of 30 men. A tiger will spend hours preparing a carcass. Eventually, they will digest almost every part, except the large bones and stomach. Behind the canines, the tiger's teeth clamp together like power scissors, cutting through skin and muscle. A tiger needs at least 18 pounds of meat a day to survive, but it has been known to digest up to 5 times that amount in a single leisurely meal.
Coming up, a rare glimpse of Siberian tigers at night, when Wild Discovery continues. This program is brought to you in part by Exxon and the Save the Tiger Fund.
There are no boundaries, no language barriers, not when the cause is so great. And though time is running short, there is still hope to help save one of the world's most beloved creatures. Hope that when these children have children, there will still be tigers roaming the earth. Exxon is proud to play a part in the Save the Tiger Fund. To help, call 1-800-5-TIGERS.
Is iams good for life? Well, research suggests cats can lower your blood pressure and help their owners live longer, healthier lives. In return, help your cat live a long, healthy life. The wholesome ingredients in iams are more digestible, so more nutrition stays in your cat, and cats love the taste. Iams Cat Foods, good for life, from the Iams Company.
Buy 12 cans of Iams cat or dog food, now slow-cooked with real broth, and pick up a free insulated mug with money-saving coupons inside.
The fierce claws of the Siberian tiger are only unsheathed when hunting. When the animal is resting or walking, the claws are tucked in beside the soft pads. These sensitive feet are no match for the hoofed prey, which will travel across thorny, split ground in the heat of the day to avoid the enemy. The Siberian tiger is nearly twice as heavy and more thick-set than its Indian and Sumatran counterparts, and at least a size larger than its cousin, the lion. Average weight for a male tiger is about 650 pounds, while a female weighs in at about 350 pounds. An average male measures up to 10 feet in length from nose to tail. As is typical of their species, Siberian tigers are most active at night. But these tigers live very close to the land of the midnight sun, and for much of the year, night is only a few hours long. This rare footage of a Siberian tiger shows the animal in its nocturnal environment. But the lone assassin has a beguiling quality that is both arresting and seductive. There is little physical contact between male and female tigers prior to mating. They will circle each other, maintaining a keen interest. In this case, the female can smell the scent of the male who is taking great pains to mark his own stamping ground. There will be little doubt that this territory belongs to this male. The tiger's hearing is one of its best assets for gathering information, but the tiger will often use its ears to send non-verbal cues. When threatened, the tiger will twist the tips of the ears until the familiar white dots are facing the front. A tiger's territory always includes water, and they will spend most of the summer drinking or wallowing in muddy pools to escape the heat of the day. As with all cats, grooming is an important part of the tiger's day. Pests are a constant annoyance. And this female is pestered by tiny mosquitoes who nest in the muddy ponds of the reserve. Early morning is time for hunting, and an unfortunate pheasant makes a convenient breakfast. Most tigers will sleep after eating, but there is always at least one eye open. Few animals have better sight than the tiger. Its long-distance sight and color vision are five times better than that of man. Tigers have a reflective patch in the retina called a tapetum which makes the best of poor light. While the shape of an object isn't easily discernible, the tiger's sensitivity to movement is acute.
Reserve's most favored resident makes himself at home when Wild Discovery continues. About tigers, information about tiger domains, migration patterns and feeding habits. They're giving us a better picture of tiger behavior, and they're made possible with the help of Exxon. Because unless we work together, tigers could be gone in a flash. To help, call 1-800-5-TIGERS. A week's worth of close encounters. Shark Week is back. New shows, never-before-seen footage. Feed your need. Hover with hammerheads, search for the giant, and get prehistoric with a megalodon. No one else gets this close. Feed your need. Shark Week, beginning Sunday at 9 Eastern, 8 Central on the Discovery Channel. Explore your world. Live from the ocean floor, be there. Technology has made it possible to see history as it happens. And now it will take you inside Titanic live. Were the third-class gates locked? Analyze the damage from inside the hull and be there live in places unseen since April 15, 1912. Titanic Live, a night to remember. August 16th at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, only on the Discovery Channel. Feed your need. Enter the Spot the Fin and Win sweepstakes. You could win one of 8 trips for 2 to some of the world's great shark zones, plus $2,000 spending money, or one of thousands of other prizes. Just watch Shark Week. When you spot this fin with our toll-free number, call for your chance to win. Check out discovery.com for details, and keep watching for more sharks, more prizes, each night during Shark Week. Beginning Sunday at 9 Eastern and Pacific on the Discovery Channel.
Not all tigers know hostility at an early age. 11-month-old Huan Wan, Chinese for beautiful one, is a little more than a boisterous tabby. Born at the Siberian Tiger Breeding Center near the Chinese city of Having, Huan Wan's future looks as hopeless as his back legs, crippled by an obscure bone disease. But Minchu Sir became far more than this tiger's keeper.
Was one of 4 cubs born to one of our female tigers. But it was the mother's first litter, and she was very nervous. So she stayed in her inner den for 2 weeks before anyone could get near her. By then, Wenwen was the only cub still alive. The others were weak when they were born, and the mother had rejected them. Wenwen was crippled, so I took over as his mother. He sleeps under my bed. He is my baby.
It's unlikely Huan Huan would have survived without the special care of his keeper. Minchu Sir exercises the little cub to strengthen his withered back legs and feeds him daily vitamins and minerals for his young bones. And while Juan Juan will never be able to walk as well as his peers, he has no trouble getting around. Juan Juan isn't happy today. For the first time, his regular doctor is too busy to check the little cub. The breeding center has engaged the service of a new medic. The unfortunate stand-in gives up after a nervous attempt to check the tiger's heartbeat. For the moment, Juan Juan will have to miss his checkup, at least until his regular doctor returns. It's no coincidence that the tiger breeding center was built so close to the Russian border. This is an area at the heart of the Siberian tiger's original habitat. The region, once known as Manchuria, was occupied over the past century by the Russians and the Japanese before reverting back to Chinese rule in 1950. The breeding center here was set up as a last effort to learn more about the elusive Siberian tiger, perhaps the least understood of all the great cats.
We don't like to keep tigers in cages, but it is the only way we can study them closely. We need to learn more about the Siberian tiger so we can help it survive into the next century. No one ever sees it in the forest anymore.
The research done by the breeding center has shown that tigers prefer female keepers. It's a behavioral quirk which the center is happy to indulge. Here, the diligent female keepers keep daily notes: vitamin dosage, the amounts of meat eaten by each tiger, feces and urine checks, and general observations. Most of the 30 Siberian tigers here have been born in captivity. Animals like Xian Mao, whose front paw was amputated when she contracted gangrene as a cub. She's 7 now and lives in the next cage to her mother, who at 25 years old is believed to be the world's oldest Siberian tiger. In the wild, competing for food and territory, few tigers live longer than 13 or 14 years. Flattened ears of the tiger tells us he's irritable, anxious for food. Tigers here are housed in individual cages for sleeping and feeding, but most are given the run of the courtyard for exercise and, in some cases, socializing. But it's feeding time, and each tiger awaits its 20 pounds of fresh beef. In summer, the Siberian tiger drinks heavily, and fresh water is provided daily. As with most carnivores, the tiger is most ferocious when feeding, and the keeper approaches each animal with considerable care. Tigers tigers in the courtyard are lured into cages by meat. A door is then closed with an external winch. Animals are seldom fed in the open area, as it leads to fighting. Juan is happier today. His regular doctor is back from the city, and the little cub allows himself to be checked over, but not without a little resistance. It's not a procedure Juan enjoys, but he does like this doctor and his firm hand.
Cuddle up when Wild Discovery continues.
Fans from all ends of the earth have begun to kindle the fire and breathe life into her flame. We at Exxon are proud to play a part in this global effort to help keep the Tigers' fire burning brightly. To find out how you can make a difference, call 1-800-5-TIGERS.
Want to color your gray beard or mustache and get a natural look? It's easy with Just for Men Gel.
The people that blow things up for a living on Discover Magazine and spend a day in the life of Engine Company 13 on Firehouse. Tomorrow on the Discovery Channel. Sunday on Wild Discovery, he's back, he's on the hunt, and he's wilder than ever.
I tell you what, when there's food around, they go ballistic.
Steve Irwin takes on the biggest, the smallest, and the most dangerous.
He just bit a hold of my head. Lucky enough, he let go.
In honor of Shark Week, Steve Irwin takes the plunge.
A bit too close for my liking.
As only Steve can. Sharks Down Under, a world premiere Wild Discovery. Sunday at 8 Eastern, 7 Central.
Explore your world.
On the Discovery Channel.
The new Fox Family Channel is giving it all away. Win $100,000 for your dream house, a Florida vacation, or over 1,000 other prizes. It's the Getaway House Giveaway. Pick up an entry form at Wendy's. While you're there, try a fresh stuffed pita. Find the mystery character in one of our new shows. Write it down and mail it in. Hurry, the giveaway's gone September 15th. Go to Wendy's and watch Fox Family Channel.
The art of tennis.
Look at them. But they just hide it behind the wall. Oh, oh.
Hundreds of miles away at the Beijing Zoo, four dubious bundles of fur are being introduced to the world. It's the first time these four-week-old cubs have left the inner den of the zoo's Siberian tiger enclosure, and mother Zhu Sen is showing her concern. Sight is still a novelty for these cubs. Tigers are blind until at least 3 weeks old. They stumble around their mother's body, lunging for a nipple and the ensuing nourishment. In the wild, the first litter has little chance for survival. Her chances improve with each brood as the female hones her maternal skills. In contrast, the survival rate for tigers in captivity is now close to 100%. The little cubs weigh about 7 pounds now, and most are able to crawl. But it will be a few weeks before their short, stubby paws will carry them with any confidence. Cubs are born with blurred markings, and it will be 2 years before the downy fur takes on the distinctive stripes of their adult kin. This is Jusin's third litter. She was born at the zoo 7 years ago, and her placid nature and gentleness make her a good mother. Cubs are usually born in litters of 2 to 4, and the mother has a short gestation of about 4 months. In the forest, tigers have to be taught how to be tigers, and in 2 years, mother must transform her tiny, helpless bundle of fluff into the most startling predator on Earth. Siberian tiger cubs are at their most vulnerable between birth and suckling. Finding a nipple in mother's thick striped fur can be a daunting process for a blind cub, particularly if it's doing battle with siblings. But it is generally accepted. If a cub can suckle, it will survive. First-time mothers will often reject or refuse to feed cubs. It's an unfamiliar situation, and many are nervous about the sudden appearance of the tiny little creatures. Cubs will mew as soon as they are born, and only a mother's rough tongue scaling the soft, furry bodies can create calm. The tiger mother is hugely protective of her litter, and in the forest, time is divided between hunting for food and defending her clan. Unlike lions, she has no support group to help and must have nourishment to feed her cubs. This protective streak doesn't only exist in the wild. Jusin has never seen a camera and decides to check it out firsthand. Cubs have milk teeth by the time they are 4 weeks old, soft nibblers that will later grow into the tiger's full weaponry. It will be another month before these cubs are introduced to meat. They will be weaned when they are 2 months old, but for this family, food will never be a problem. In the forest, cubs are taken on hunting trips when they are 6 months old. They learn about territory and catching prey by stealth. And at 18 months, they cast off the family and learn about being alone. In just a few weeks, this family will go its separate ways. At 6 months old, the cubs will be placed in separate enclosures, and within 2 years, they will be sent to other zoos for breeding or as part of an exchange program. Tigers born in zoos are never released back into the wild. Their dependence on regular feeding make it unlikely that many would survive the rigors of the forest.
Siberian tiger faces an uncertain future when Wild Discovery continues.
Killed for their fur and organs, these magnificent creatures have become an endangered species. Exxon is sponsoring a program that protects tigers from poachers. And to judge by its success, things are starting to click. To help, call 1-800-5-TIGERS.
We put Florida on sale. 4 days, 3 nights in Orlando. Just...
The summer forests of Siberia are home to a million living things. But it is the region's largest creature that is at greatest risk. The collapse of the Soviet Union has brought a poaching revival, and the tiger, cut loose from the authority which once protected it, is today at the mercy of profiteering Russian gangs. There is more optimism on the Chinese side of the border. Law and order have all but cut out poaching. And as numbers revive, animals from the Siberian Tiger Reserve and the breeding center will be eased back into the wild. Still, saving the tiger is an ambitious and costly exercise. And for a nation with a higher priority of feeding its vast population, the purse is stretched to the limit. More splendid than the Siberian tiger. Its stealth and cunning combine with an awesome weaponry that make it one of the most feared animals on the planet. Now the future of this graceful animal is totally dependent on a traditional enemy. For man, it's an opportunity to make amends.
Discovery. He may be king, but she's the leader of the hunt, the queen of the beasts, as Wildcats continues on Wild Discovery tomorrow. Want to learn more about what you see on Wild Discovery? Log on to Wild Discovery Wired at www.discovery.com. Ask questions and get answers from experts who know. But next, seeds of life, but also clues to murder. Seeds of destruction on New Detectives, next on the Discovery Channel.